Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Let's try a second stab at solving Odelia's problem from yesterday. She needed to create a pie chart of just the items greater than 4%. And yesterday, I used a filter to do that. But today, we're going to take a look at a different type of chart. If we go into pie, there's two. It's called pie of pie and bar of pie. They both work basically the same. So, it really doesn't matter. I'm going to choose either one. Click Next in step 3. I want to turn off the legend. And on the data label, show category, name, and value, and click Finish. Now, here's what happens. Anything that is below a certain threshold gets put into one wedge called Other, and then it's detailed out here on the right-hand side. I'm going to right-click anywhere in the pie, Format Data Series, and we can change the default. So, I'm going to split this not by position, but by a percentage value, and say that the second plot contains all values less than 4%. That automatically moves anything less than 4% out there. And the other thing we can do is we can control the size of that. If you really don't even want that to show, we can just take it down to practically nothing. So it'll be very unobtrusive. Gap width, we can set the gap width up fairly high to make sure that the labels try not to get on top of each other. Here, let me actually take this down to 0. And the gap width set to the maximum, click OK. I can imagine there would be a situation where you could actually just kind of hide this out here with a nice white box and no one would even know that it's there. Not the best solution in the whole world. To get rid of those leader lines that are going between the series, Format Data Series, it was an option here called Series Lines. You know, so we could format that box that way it didn't have a border around it. Format Auto Shape, Line, None. Click OK. All right. And you start to get to something relatively close. The advantage of this is that as the numbers change, we don't have to recalculate the threshold. Excel does that for us automatically. So, you know, if this number would become 1400, I have to resize the name of the box. But items will automatically go from one box to the other based on the size. So this might be a little bit better. The big advantage of this is that we show that other slice. In the method from yesterday, everyone under 4% just disappears from the chart, so we can see the size of the entire pie. Thanks to Odelia for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.